All right, y'all ready?
Yeah,
let's do it.
You want to jump in, Pat?
What?
You want to kick it off?
I can kick it off.
Yeah. All right. You're the most popular on the channel.
You think?
Yeah,
you're the youngest.
And also, never wear your hair down. I've been meaning to tell you that. You did it for so long up that down. You just feel like you look like the girl from The Ring.
I look biblical.
You do.
The girl from The Ring.
You know she had her hair down.
Yeah,
I'm saying, like, if she was a culture, I'd be like, bro, get back in the TV.
Woman with my hair down.
You be coming out of YouTube videos though.
They ain't ready for them all.
And keep that in there, too. So here was a good joke. Don't cut that out to get right to the point. You got to keep it in.
Yeah,
please, though.
Dang it. Start the podcast off with my misery.
Right. All right,
do we got to not cuss on this?
Oh, no. We back at all deaf.
Fuck all that shit. Yeah.
That was unnecessary, though. You got my wife behind doing the thing. Let's explain why we're in here, by the way. We should explain why we're in my office.
Okay.
No, we ain't got no building, y'all.
Yeah, right here.
Oh,
this is your single, though.
Okay, for sure. What's up, everybody? Hey. We are back.
Yeah, cuz.
In a, let's take that out.
No, that's going to stay in, too.
I don't know.
I'll do it.
Okay.
Listen, y'all, what up? It's your boy, Cam on stage, and the squad is back. Bang, 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 bang,
bang, bang, bang,
bang. Gunshot and stuff.
That's what we wanted?
Yeah. I'm confident. You weren't confident. You were like, hey, guys, are we back?
I'm important.
Anyway, it's the jeans. He's never confident when he wears jeans. Look how they look. Look how they look on his legs.
Stop wearing jeans, nigga.
This is the worst start ever.
You know he was in band. Oh, is that an E flat?
No, it's been like 6 months. I ain't been running, guys. I can wear jeans. No, you can't, nigga.
So anyway, the squad is back. The whole channel is back. If you don't know, now you know. We should have done a podcast the first time. Maybe we wouldn't have closed down. But
straight out of foreclosure.
And the funny thing is, we had so many meetings about starting a podcast, and we just never could get to it. Right. So the company closed down. Individually, we were like, well, I'll start my own.
Well, we did start a podcast.
Yeah. Internet's undefeated.
You know what's funny?
But the internet is defeated because y'all podcast got turned off.
Well, you know what's funny?
It wasn't as true as you thought.
You know what's funny? We shot that the day we were all fired.
Damn.
Wow.
We came in, we shot it. They had me editing it. I was like, yeah, do this. This is all post, right? And then at like 5 o'clock, they were like, all right, staff meeting. And so like we had done a whole day of work and they were just like, yeah.
Listen, when I got fired from my job at Key Bank, they fired me on my lunch break. I was like, y'all knew I was getting fired at 8 o'clock. Let's not stand on ceremony,
that's
Mr. Wayne.
I had
just put some chicken thighs in the microwave. The microwave was like, ding. I sat down. He was like, can I talk to you? I was like, you knew you were going to do this.
Everybody was fresh out of meetings. We were all like walking in like, yeah, you're going to do the thing that's going to post. Yeah, you're going to do the thing that we're going to do tomorrow.
Funniest thing about that, the higher ups were looking at y'all like,
little guy.
None of that going to matter.
What's his name? Big guy was there. I want to say his name. He was there, and he was like, hey, Tahir, how are you? I was like, how? What are you doing there? He was like, oh, just taking care of some things. I was like, okay.
It ain't right.
Did he wink at you?
This was right after we had finished
why do you got a box with my name on it? Don't worry about it. Don't get involved.
Speaking of which, does everybody have boxes?
So when Tahir was there, you got fired twice?
I got fired twice.
You better
be
living
again. As a freelancer?
They hired me. They did paperwork that day to get hired back, and then they fired me again a couple hours later.
We actually have your enter and your exit paperwork right here.
Yeah, they signed them both.
Here's the weirdest part. Aaron and I worked for two more days after that.
Really?
We shot the Tony show.
Yeah.
We shot for 2 days on a ghost, like a ghostly production. We couldn't tell anybody. We were just walking around. Everybody's like, so same time next week. And we were like, every time there was a good scene and a good joke, I was just like, this is never going to see the light of day.
So anyway, all that being said, we are actually back. All Def is back under new management.
Yes.
The gang's back. All that you love.
Gang.
So we decided to start a podcast we're going to call ourselves the OG Squad.
Okay.
Okay, because we were the ones that were there from the very beginning of time. Pat actually is the oldest ranking member of All Def.
He was there.
He was there even before me.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah, he
was there. It was only Russell and like a few people.
He was somebody else's assistant. And I started on Monday and I knew she was getting fired on Friday. And I was just looking at her like, She was having meetings, and I was like, man, you better schedule them this week.
As a personal assistant.
I know.
When she told me she was gone, I was like, so.
Forget all that. What about
me? I know you're upset about what happened to me. No, don't forget you. What right. about
tough break for you.
Should I put fired in your calendar?
So you're free from today for the rest of all of this.
Cool. Right. So you just opened up, is what you're saying.
So, here's the difference between this podcast and the other one, because Meg has Mommy Needs a Break, mm-hmm. Patton and Tahir have Internet Scary, me and Double have Righteous and Ratchet, and we didn't want to cross any of those, so me and Pat came up with this idea called Versus, and basically...
Oh, you want me to rap because you know the one to years
oh,
came
no.
out?
No.
Oh, okay.
So basically what Versus is we have two topics that we are going to decide which is funny or not funny, but... What better. You agree with yeah. more. And these will not be topical. So, guys, anything that's trending on the internet, keep watching
much.
The podcast that you watch. Whatever mm-hmm. y'all be talking about on Diapers and Me.
Diapers and Me?
So, baby,
breast is only getting more and more
so
disrespectful.
The baby cried when it was wet.
So, bibs or paper towels. My kids are
such
old,
man.
So I don't have
You're
to do that.
Man.
But also, my kids don't talk to me anymore, so at least your baby still loves me. But my, you know what's funny? My kids think we're cringe, but they be watching the podcast like, you were funny on this, but yeah. in the living room.
In real
you were taking it
in the living room. You were taking it.
You're funny on camera.
That's your third dinner in a row. You ain't getting no laugh. Yo,
your son's voice is deeper than mine.
Let Yo. Me tell you what.
I saw your video and I was like, it can't be that deep. He walked in like, what's up, man?
Maybe I knew about that. I just didn't care.
It's deeper.
He was shooting dice outside with some of the gang members.
When I call him and he answers, I'll be like, who you think you're talking to? And he just says, yes. I
yeah, because he says, yes, father, too. He's like, yes, father. You're like,
like an apprentice?
Yeah. He always calls him father and mother. He never says, yes, yeah, dad, you know, yes, father.
Wait, did you tell your kids to call
no.
you father?
No. Why would I do that? I
Jojo
said sire.
Do
yes.
Yes.
No,
Jojo,
I'm doing
said,
it. Yeah. I want them to call you my lead.
This son's gonna start talking like a wizard.
When you come in my room, Your Grace, the remote. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Away with you, cousin. I want you to call me Game of Thrones stuff. If I want. But now my youngest son started doing it to make fun of my older son. But so now they just both do it, and I just be like,
Joe
bro,
does it too. Yeah. That's hilarious.
Yes, he be on, yeah.
That's a commitment that's to funny. Keep it going.
Yeah, Zay been on hey, it for father. Like 2 years.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
a joke.
Yeah, funny. He started off as a joke and then he just kept doing it.
I remember when I first heard him do it when we were on tour and he was like, father, can I get something to eat? I was like,
that sounds very...
So you know what's funny about that? When I was a kid, my dad, when I was being sarcastic, I would say sire instead of yes, sir. Mm-hmm. I'd be like, yes, sire. And he was like, keep it up. I was like...
I'm a rebel.
I defy things.
So anyway, Meg is in town for the week.
Yes.
So we're going to shoot three of these with Meg. And then we're going to shoot dad jokes. We're just telling y'all everything. Dad mm-hmm. jokes, great taste. Meg's going to be in all the great taste. I wish you just tell them everything.
The last 10, last 10 great taste.
This is the last 10 great taste.
Oh, that's mm-hmm. right.
Believe it or not, we do read the comments. And we know y'all was like, we want the OG squad back, Pat, Doe, Kev, Tahir. You know, some combination of another person. That sixth person is up for grabs.
Yeah.
So we are shooting 10 final great tastes starting Wednesday of this week. And that's it. After that, great taste. Rest
retired.
In peace. Just keep watching the old
just keep
ones.
Keep binging. We don't want to see it die.
Keep binging. Because we thought about doing more, but me, you know, Pat sent the ideas. He was like, we don't have a year's worth. We've been going for like 2 years.
We should have an episode, and you got to pick your favorite great taste episode and argue about it.
That's why you were let go earlier.
You know that started May 2017?
Hey, y'all.
2017?
Wow. I thought it was at least
so 2020, the episodes that aired in 2020 will be the third year that we aired episodes.
Wow. Mm-hmm. And we didn't take that many breaks. At one point, it was just all
every
week,
Saturday.
Every
and that's why we didn't want to go back to, like, you know, best flavored water, Dasani, Arrowhead. Oh, I hate Arrowhead. Like, we didn't want that to happen. We wanted to Seinfeld it. We want to end it strong.
Yeah.
So consider this the final season of Great Taste. Yep. And Meg will be in all those. Meg lives in Atlanta with her little baby. So she'll be coming back and forth to shoot with us from time to time. So, but she'll be in these first three episodes and then she'll be back.
Yep.
And then we're shooting Roast Me and Squad Reacts. And then the best part is we're going to be shooting new content.
Hey.
Because we didn't want to just shoot all the old stuff forever. Like, the channel needs to evolve and thrive. So this is all Def 2.0. We're giving you everything you loved with the people you love. And then we're moving forward. But this podcast will be the OG squad. You always have at least three of us. You know, we had different schedules, so obviously we won't all be able to be in every episode, but you at least have at least three of us.
Yeah. Nah.
You think we should have guests on this?
Nah.
Forget it.
Nah.
Let's keep it.
Unless you're like a, you know what I mean? Because I want to introduce the new, I think we should introduce new talent on new projects and stuff. Yeah. Like, definitely we should do that. Right. But, excuse me.
Why was that? Wow. You want to spit that out?
That's the room smells like chili dogs.
But
it still tastes like the food. He's like, I'm not letting it go.
I'm all the way over here.
We were already laughing.
Now take it further.
So this podcast is kind of for people who've been around for the whole time.
Yeah.
And with the people you love. So we'll kind of keep this to ourselves. And this is ours, man. Just leave us alone. We're going to be doing this with our friends. Right. And then the other people, we'll get like Tony, Trev, like, but you got to have been a made man, so right. to speak. You know, okay. we're like the made man. We're Sicilian.
Man, woman.
But we don't know our...
And women.
The women, they kind of weren't in it, in the mafia.
They counted the money.
I didn't make up the mafia. I'm just saying, they didn't have a made woman. I never seen nobody in Goodfellas like, and Sandra's going to kill you.
Cecilia.
Sandra never came back with the wire thing.
Oh my God.
You know, the wife knew. I'm just saying.
He got you there. Yeah. He got you there.
So, okay. Don't load made men then. And women. So, made men and women. So, Tony, Trev, D's. Who else was Cleo? Cleo was in there pretty good. Richie Loco, the people you've seen before.
Yeah.
But
he was in there pretty good.
Yeah, but mostly I'll just say, all right, man. So explain the thing, and we've done enough to get started, right?
Yeah.
Oh, let's explain why we're in my office. Do we do that?
No.
We ain't got no building right now.
That was enough just for us.
I mean, that's the truth. We don't have
we
a
ain't
place
got no building right now. We kind of in between places right now.
We're in between blessings.
Y'all know what it's like.
Airbnb of entertainment. We have no physical location.
We just need space to pull this stuff up.
Y'all know what it's like to go from couch to
yeah,
couch.
Yeah, man. We got out of a relationship. This is the get on your feet period. We just like, hey, man, he kicked me out. You mind if I just crash here for a while?
Leaving on a couch.
We got our to go bag, you know what I'm saying? Got some drawers in there, a toothbrush. So anyway, we're in my office, so that's why we actually, Meg was like, why don't we cover it up? And we were like, we don't have nothing to cover it up with. We're just in it. They're gonna know we're in here anyway.
Like, rock with it,
we shoot other stuff in here, so we're in here for like the first for now. Right. We're gonna be fine. We're gonna have a just give us some time, guys. We actually thought about waiting to do the content until we were, you know, set. But we wanted to get to y'all right away. So bear with us. You'll probably see us in different setups until we're like set up all the way. But just the videos will always be the same. Also, this is a podcast as well. So if you want to listen to this at work, you can go wherever podcasts are found. It's on Apple, Spotify, and then the other ones. I don't
Google
really know
Play.
What else. People
are there any other ones?
Google Play.
There's like Deezer. Google Play, Deezer, Stitcher,
SoundCloud,
iHeart.
But I never hear anybody like I was on iHeart.
I found you on iHeart.
Yeah, it's almost always Apple or Spotify.
Google Play.
So if you want to take us on the road or while you're at work, you can't have your screen up. It'll air every Monday. By the way, it'll air every Monday.
You know y'all gonna watch this at work. Video too.
Yeah. But it
doesn't have another screen over.
You know how to do it. But we do have this in podcast form. So the first couple episodes will have no ads. Eventually we'll have ads in it, and that's how this continues to get going. So we don't want to hear no crap about none of that, because y'all don't want to pay for Roast Me either, you little... Anyway, let's keep going. The last time I called people broke, they got mad. So we're going to be generating income in a lot of different ways. So the content is free to you. You're going to have to deal with some ads. You're just going to have to deal for
last
it.
Last time I called people broke, they got mad. That's usually the response.
Broke boy? Thanks, man. Appreciate
that.
You're a great guy.
So anyway, all that. How long have we been going now?
For like an
that's
hour.
Man, more shut up and let's do the thing.
15? That's perfect, 15.
I was about to say, this is pretty solid.
All right, now we are ready to go. We had to catch them up. Yeah, it's been a long time. Shouldn't have left you.
Necessary.
Without
necessary.
Dope content to watch to no. set to.
See, there you go.
You did it so well.
I was so close.
One yard
you just had to fumble it.
The Seahawks. All you had to do was hand it to Marshawn Lynch. I was like, pass it. All right, so you're set it up.
Come on.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. So the first verses that we have, we're going to go with sex versus eating. Which do you prefer?
Now, let me ask you one clarifying question before we start. Does eating coochie count?
Yeah, because that
that's, you know,
thing.
It's a term of endearment.
No, not in
it's
this
more
case.
Licking.
No, that still falls like... in sex.
Okay, so that's considered sex. Yeah. We mean like the physical eating food for nourishment.
I was not expecting this clarity question at all.
The kids is here. Listen, you understand me?
We're literally one minute into the podcast and he says, eating coochie cap.
Is that cool?
This is tough. Like, I knew this was happening all weekend and I'm still kind of frozen.
It's easy for me. Sex.
Come on, man. You didn't get to four horned with the sex. You spent a lot more time with pork chops than Pam.
Nah, sex is just good.
It was sex and the food.
That's what I was about to say. He's
lighting
sex
candles with
the
pork chops. That's too chocolate on the marshmallows.
Tenderloins and marshmallows.
Wait, y'all didn't hear him. He said you spent more time with pork chops than Pam.
It kind of got lost in translation. But I didn't want to repeat
that. That was more important that we hear that. That's hilarious. Pork chops than Pam.
Okay, Doug, go ahead.
Sex, not because sex is just always good. It's never
for her too.
Yes. I done lost some weight. It's different. It's 486
she
sex.
She's like, doggy style, like, dude, I want to try something new. You want to break your hip? Do you?
Every time after sex, the girl goes,
when he gets
how long was I out?
No, so shut up, no.
That is terrible.
I've lost,
how long was I out?
I don't even know what he was meaning, so I just want to move past it as quickly as possible.
So this is my thing.
Suffocation.
Now that I've lost a bunch of weight, like, sex is much better, man, so it's always lit.
For her?
Yeah, I'm out there. I'm out there, playboy.
Have you, so like...
Hey, it's lit. It's lit.
What can you do now that you couldn't do it for
her? Everything. I only have one position at 400.
So when you go on top, she like...
She not nervous? She not nervous? She be goes, like, okay. Yeah.
Can you imagine, dope?
She puts the roller coaster thing on.
Funny thing about that. One time I was smashing a chick, right? And I was trying to like hold myself up. She was like, no.
Smashing.
No, for real. She was like, no, put it on me. It's cool. She was like, put your weight on me. I was like,
said, put it on
me? No, she was like, for real, you need to be comfortable. I was like, all right. So I let it go. She was like, wait. All right. No, not all of it.
I bit off more than I can chew.
Like, nigga, what?
Not all of it.
Were you holding yourself up?
Nigga, yes, because you know how we do with the arms. So I put it down. She was just like, wait.
Oh my God.
Not all of it.
Not all of it.
30%. 30%.
She went to survival mode. She's like, wait, that was great. Hold on. What?
Hold on. Can you plank? Can you plank it? It went from here to
here. Can you plank?
The forearm.
He's like, I wonder why she was shadowboxing before we had sex.
I hated him.
Speed bag in his
boob. All right, I'm ready. She's punching herself in the face.
Give it all to me. Boobs.
Oh my gosh.
Shut
my
up,
favorite.
Man. Sex is better than food. Get back to the topic. Okay. I love it.
Jesus Christ.
It's never a bad time for sex. Right, so I'm always going sex.
That's the show. That's it. That's the episode.
We're done.
So my thing, I'll jump in.
Oh, man.
I love sex too, but you eat much more than you have sex.
Yeah.
You eat every day. You sex, you know, some days, not all the days. You be out of town and stuff. So I could go a lot long. I mean, literally, like, the enjoyment of food. Some food is as good as sex.
No, it's not.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my
food
gosh.
Is as good as sex.
Okay, let me tell you. We've all eaten, like, the first bite of something new that is perfect, and that first, like...
It's a good list.
That's like slide in.
Start naming some foods that are better.
That's the first slide in, and the first bite of like Ruth's Chris Porterhouse.
Oh my God!
Very.
You taking that with the first slide in?
Your brain is like for both.
Low key. That's kind of true.
Yes,
it's kind of true. Steak, that first
buttery steak.
And what do you always do after sex? You want to eat. You hungry.
There you go.
That's a good point.
But you can't just go right into sex after eating, though. If you full,
not
you
what
can't
you
smash
eat.
You can't smash on a full stomach.
Yes, I can.
So Doughboy's always on a full stomach. So.
You should not smash on a full stomach.
I mean, I got to fit this in somewhere, right?
Hold on. Is it like swimming? Like, I need 30 before.
So. You got to get it when you can.
You can't do your best moves.
You can't have
on a
sex after you eat?
You can't get your best moves in on the full
stomach. What moves are you be doing? You don't look like you be having no type of moves.
Have you been to my Yelp page?
By this part of your jacket, this part of your jacket tells me you don't have no moves.
What?
You got the Paul Bunyan special.
What you won't do is lie about it, okay?
I'm not telling the truth. That jacket is dumb.
Yeah, it really is. Why do you have corduroy shoulders?
Now, first of all,
why do you have corduroy shoulders?
Hold on.
When I bought this in Amsterdam, I was like, it is a nice jacket. I like the jacket.
But then you put it on with these clothes. You got sweatpants on and Jordans on.
All right, originally, My bottom wasn't supposed to be showing. We were at another place, and I was like, "This is all."
But
this
you still had to make the decision for this to go on today.
I thought you wore this.
This is lit. Listen, it should be on the blue.
It should be lit on fire.
Double Boy can never give fashion advice.
Absolutely
lying to me.
Him or Pat.
No,
not with jeans.
Pat don't even wear socks.
Pat is evil. No,
Pat does not.
I'm barely wearing anything.
Pat, you don't wear socks.
That is not true. You got on Jeggings, my guy.
Pat's never gonna draw attention with his clothes. Bad or good? No,
really. Yeah, they'll be like, "You see Pat's outfit? That ain't never
happened." Every room he walks in, not a turned head.
He's like,
not a bit of interest.
Neither interest nor disdain. People are just not going to notice you.
This is true.
You can see Pat and be like, "Did I see Pat today?" But you have the bracelets in the hair, like,
and the ridiculous tattoos.
Enough, yeah.
Doughboy.
We're skipping over the baby pink Chevy jersey with the nipples showing.
You do look ridiculous.
Your
nipples are showing.
Your nipples are budding right now.
You need to put Band-Aid
on.
My
nipples be showing, though.
Because you leak.
You got some heart.
Also, who reps Chevy?
Right around 4 months when the breasts start swelling up, that's what you got going on.
My
right
nipples
now
do be showing too.
My nipples are always hard.
I don't know why.
Why?
You a thot. I got the thin pants on, no drawers on.
You got the equivalent of gray sweatpants on his shirt.
You look
like
a third
grade. I was like, why is he squatting
grade
like this? He just tied shoes. He was like, let me tie my shoe. What are you doing?
The nerve to wear something like athletic. On Adidas pie eating team.
Yeah. How does it feel, you whore?
That was good.
He's called a timeout.
That was good.
He just called a timeout.
The Adidas pie eating team. Like, we warming up. Well, this we got blueberry today, man.
He got like a montage commercial. Just
what was that?
When I wake up a winner. Put the pie in the oven.
He got pie crust on his mouth.
I missed y'all.
Oh my god.
The pie eating team is fantastic.
That was the best thing of the episode.
I'm going to wake up in the middle of the night and I'm like, Adidas pie eating.
Boys,
imagine Adidas. Adidas hit me up like, we want you part of the squad. Oh, they're like, basketball? No. We're getting into competitive eating.
Oh. He got like a giant black and white billboard over Times Square.
With a piece of pie. Pumpkin pie.
What do you know about commitment?
Pie or die.
Pie or die.
I don't want this company to be back no more. I want it to be gone again. Okay, back to eating or sex.
It's all fun when it ain't you, huh?
It is. Back on topic.
Eating
you guys
or sex?
Are off
eating or sex?
Wait, so you're sex. No, you're eating.
No, I'm eating.
Yeah, I'm going to say eating too.
You're eating. Because
it's more essential to life.
Okay.
Dear, we need it.
Sex.
Yeah, come on, man.
Sex. What?
Yeah.
Because he don't get any.
Yeah. Man, don't be foolish now. I think it's great, man. It's like I was never amazing at sports outside of tennis, but sex is something.
You didn't have to tell us that. And look at you. I was never good at sports. Really?
So he was on the tennis team, right? In his high school and his college. Yeah. You know when he walked up, they was like, "Ah, we got it."
I got that one. That's me. I got him.
Because you know you judge the athletes. Like, man, they look like they good.
They nothing started handing him all the rackets. You're the equipment manager, right?
I got freckles.
Ain't no way. You not playing. Yeah. You're the racket guy, right?
Man, calling me red bone on the court. I was like, I'm a man, bro. But so sex funny is just, I mean, you know what it is? Like, when you go to Ruth Chris, you know what that steak is going to be like. It doesn't matter what Ruth Chris you go to. It's always going to be the same.
Never
what
go
is
to
this thing you guys are saying?
Ruth Chris.
He's just got a fat throat.
I said it right.
No, you said Ruth Chris.
Ruth Chris Steakhouse. No matter where you go, you know it's going to taste like that. But sex is always different. There's no person in sex that's exactly
that's
the same
like
as
every
the last
okay
person.
So they go to a new restaurant that you've never been to. That's the same exact feeling.
People are that you've never had. We're creatures of habit. We typically go to the same places to go eat. Now, if you're out of town, you might try something different. But for the most part, you have a top five restaurants that you always
and
go
you
to.
Probably have top five hoes.
Okay, so top five hoes.
But even here, it's the same thing.
But even in top five, they don't taste the same.
Okay, Joe, let me ask you this: because you said sex, or you said eating?
I take sex.
I don't know yet. I think I'm gonna go with sex because.
How would Quantrell feel about this?
I totally forgot about Quantrell.
Quantrell lasted longer than ADD did.
Dude, Quantrell
is still.
If you would have told me that when Doughboy said that listen, joke would have another 6 months.
Oh my god!
And the thing, we didn't even say it no more.
The people in the crowd. That and chocolate covered almonds. You did it to yourself.
Bro, that was a good 3 minutes, though.
What? Yeah, chocolate covered almonds. They're delicious.
And just dropping them on your chest.
Man. I mean, if you add gay stuff, are you putting them up your butt? No, I'm eating them.
Are you putting them up your butt?
Quantrell. I'm eating them much like everything else.
So back to you and Quantrell. What does he say about this?
I'm saying that you eat, like Kev said, you eat multiple times a day,
right.
Whereas sex is every now and then. So I think that because of the, you know, the surprise and like it being few and far between, it's better than eating. Because you could just eat a muffin right now, but you ain't just going to have sex right now.
Mm-hmm. I don't think that
and
there's...
the thing is, there's so much new foods. You go to other countries.
There's new vagina too.
Well, not for me.
But every nut... every nut is kind of the same, right? We all finish the same. Well, right. Girls don't, but we all finish the same as guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But no, it's like...
Some are better than others.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. If you hold on to it for a little, like, you take a couple of days off and then go in.
Hold
on to it. Yeah. That was a big one.
Well, no, like
they definitely. Yeah,
like you go a couple days without having sex and then you do it, you'd be like, oh,
yeah. Months, I'm saying, hold on.
Look at Pat's face. He like, oh, you take off time.
I'll be waiting, huh?
Pat be having sex with girls who sell incense wholesale. Right, so eating is sex. Detention.
Why was wholesale part of the show?
Because as I was saying, I was like, he lost confidence. Be funny.
Add another word to it. Wholesale.
And then when I was finishing wholesale, I was like, that's not gonna be it either. Just say something else.
It becomes a run-on sentence.
Okay, so I don't want to say nothing else because my confidence is all messed up.
You know what? I don't know. I'm a switch actually. Because eating low key, if you're talking about longevity, like sex, I feel like after 70, 80 years, it's just like you're not gonna. It's not gonna be the same. Whereas eating, if you offer me a sandwich in 80 years,
no, let me just
it's still gonna be good.
This will just sway you all to my side. Think of the best sexual experience you ever had in your life, whatever that was, and then think of the best meal that you ever had. If you had to pick one of those experiences, you're going to take that ass. I know that you are.
Well, the other thing is, I've had multiple meals that I thought was the best.
And you would take those over the best sex?
I've had multiple best sex.
I was like,
sex is very in the moment. You'll be like, that was the best sex I ever had in my life.
That's true. When I'm going to a new place I've never been to, I'd be more excited about the food than, like, even if it's just me and my wife, I'd be like, man, but the food, not the sex. Like, the sex, you know, that's going to be great, but new foods? Lobster tacos? The first time you had lobster tacos?
There is some credence that. What was that steakhouse that we went to in Charlotte?
Bro, perfect example. Del Frisco's, Charlotte, North Carolina.
Crazy.
Bro, appetizer.
Ugh. It's not the same Del Frisco's that's everywhere?
No, butter cake.
Because we went to Del Frisco's in LA and it wasn't.
He don't know
it was
what butter cake
fire.
Is.
You know why? Because
we
probably got like seven grandmas back there cooking.
Exactly.
And then they do it
steak,
in LA.
I looked forward to that. If my wife said, you know what, tonight, you have sex and you have Del Frisco's, I'd be like, cool, Del Frisco's. Like, not that I would pick it over sex, but I would probably look for, because like part of food you remember how good it is.
What do y'all bring it to the Wait, what do y'all bring it to the sexual table if this food is that good?
Wait, hold on.
At least you're honest about it. So I go to work, I'll be like sweating.
You don't.
You be sweating when you eat.
I go to work. I put in the effort. No matter what I'm doing, I put in the effort.
But hold on. There's less risk with eating than there is with sex. Because, look, you might get... The worst thing that can happen is what you get, like, what, food poisoning?
Yeah,
the worst thing that can happen with sex is you got something you can't get rid of for the rest of your
life,
a baby. And a kid.
Well, no, you can eating can kill you, too. A whole heart attack.
Yeah. I got no risk.
If you have a lot of bad food...
STDs does change it.
Right.
You can't get chlamydia from a sandwich.
And children
having
are even
maybe
worse
babies
than STDs.
Is crazy.
Yes. I will give you that. STDs does change it. And because babies too. Babies are the freaking worst.
And condoms. Imagine if there was a mouth condom to hide the taste a little bit.
Oh, gosh. That would take...
Eating is for sure better now.
They definitely encourage it. Like, especially with hookers. Hookers give you head with a condom on.
God damn it, to hear.
Why you know
talking up everything? I meant like a mouth condom for eating.
He's like, no, but whores.
But hookers. And syringes.
I didn't know before I paid.
There's a lot less.
Head with a condom?
There's less.
They have to do it with the condom on.
That's trash.
So here's the thing that Meg makes a good point. With sex, there's the immediate fear of pregnancy or STD.
Right.
There's no immediate fear of heart disease. You know,
diarrhea.
Over time... You know, but you're never thinking about this.
And then
maybe
it's gone
like
in a
Castle.
Couple of days.
Outside of like White Castle, you're never thinking like, if I eat this, I might, like, can you imagine outside if you had a taco castle. Like, hey, no. Man, if I eat this taco, I might have herpes.
No, but that's the thing, though. If you take like a big, but you ain't never had like a piece of steak and you eat it and you eat it too fast, you choke, people die. People be dying from steak.
I know that.
That's a fat nigga's worst nightmare, to die from a piece of steak. Like, oh,
you know, ain't no piece of steak gonna give you no problem.
You probably resurrect yourself to finish eating.
No, niggas choke to death all the time, so it can be dangerous.
Can fat niggas get the Heimlich?
Nah, because you can't put your arms around.
You got to do it.
You got to have two people hold hands. Yeah.
You just got to sock him in the stomach.
You got to Sparta kick him. What are you turning around for?
All right, so we can say eating?
No, I'm definitely saying sex, though.
I'm switching over to eating.
I'm sticking with
it. I'm saying sex, and then I'll eat the butt. For dessert, you know?
That's gross.
Huh?
You chilling?
How you chilling?
And butt?
Your breath.
He's all up in that thing. Colon.
Your insides very much stink.
Not good at all.
That's not the point of the conversation. I'm just saying what I'm
saying. All right. So that's the final is pat food.
Eating.
Sex.
Sex. Eating.
Eating.
And eating.
Who wins? Is that down the middle?
Eating.
No, there's no down the middle.
Eating wins because we have
eating
five.
One? Yeah. Eating wins that one.
I would like to ask the women that have sex with you, what do they prefer?
I'm out here in these
leaving.
Places, man.
Is leaving an
option. That girl was like,
the food.
All right, what's next to you?
All right, let's move on to young Will Smith versus the old Will Smith.
Oh, can I start on this?
Before you start, where are we stopping young Will Smith at?
Old Will Smith would be like after Earth. Everything before After Earth.
Okay.
So hold on, let me pull up his.
So wait, After Earth
was that 2008?
Like stamped him as an old person.
Yeah.
No. You should no.
Let's do it. Like old Will Smith is everything
before kids.
Before kids.
Before kids.
No, he had Trey. I was gonna say before Instagram.
Jada and Willow. No, that's not long enough.
That's not. Yeah.
Pursuit of Happiness was the first one when he had gray hair, so I think we should start there.
Okay,
no, what's the movie that he had his son in? It was
Another
Earth. No, before Pursuit of Happiness was the first one. Okay,
I would say that's where old Will started.
All right, hold on. Let me find Pursuit of Happiness.
I'm gonna say Pursuit
of Happiness started in 2006. Yes. Okay. So that would be 13 years of Will from Pursuit of Happiness to 2019.
Right.
And his career before that, are we going to start at 6 Degrees of Separation or?
Fresh Prince.
Fresh Prince?
Let's start at Fresh Prince.
All right. Fresh Prince was started in like 92. Hold on. These are the movies.
So that's young Will.
Fresh Prince started in 90.
That's perfect. So that takes
it to 90 to 2016. I mean, 90 to 2006.
Uh-huh. So 2016 and then 13. So
2006 is Pursuit of Happiness.
Okay. That makes sense. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I have a theory about this. I've been saying this for a long time. I feel like Will Smith, he's one of my favorite actors, but I feel like his movies have progressively been getting worse since like 2006. Mm-hmm. So I'm absolutely taking Young Will because Young Will was Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Okay, let me pause you real quick. And I'm going to just give you the movie since 2006 since you're saying that.
Right.
So in 2006, mm-hmm. he was in Pursuit of Happiness, I Am Legend 2007, Hancock 2008.
Yeah.
I'm just naming the big ones. Not the ones he produced. Mm-hmm. 7 Pounds 2008. Yeah. Men in Black 3.
Yeah.
After Earth.
Yeah.
Are you going to count the Anchorman cameo?
No.
He was really funny in that, but I'll give it to you.
You're going
to
count bad accent Concussion?
Hold on. I'm going to get to that. Focus. Focus in 2015. Concussion 2015.
No.
Suicide Squad 2016. Collateral Beauty 2016.
No. Right.
Bright 2017. Aladdin 2019.
I'll give him that.
Gemini Man 2019.
I heard that was terrible.
He was the genie in Aladdin.
I know, but was he good?
He saved
him. He was great.
He was the only good part about it.
And Spies in Disguise coming out and Bad Boys for Life.
What about Focus?
Focus he was in. Yeah.
So those are a bunch of just whatever mess. Yeah, it's just a mess. You know what I mean? So I'm just saying, like, you and if you're now tell me the movies before then. And then I'll show you the hits.
Oh, I mean,
you about to hear some
fire. Go through that one. Independence Day. Hitch. Men in Black.
Boom.
Yeah.
Enemy of the
State. Boom.
And that's where it starts.
He was in that bag.
Like Bad Boys 2.
Boom.
Ali.
Come on.
Men in Black 2.
Yes.
Wild Wild West.
Wild Wild West. That was the one battle.
Listen. Shark Tale.
Shark Tale.
I love Shark Tale.
Wild Wild West is a guilty pleasure movie for me.
I like it.
I know it's bad, but it's so bad.
But you know he's good when his bad movies still make 100 mil.
Yeah.
Bad Boys, I mean, Wild Wild West is considered a bad movie, but it is nowhere near as bad as After Earth. After Earth, to me,
is abysmal.
But that here's
was,
the thing
that
about
was
After
his magnum carta.
Yeah.
Like, that was just, it was horrible.
But here's the thing, I disagree with you. After Earth is not Will Smith's movie. That's Jaden's movie. Will Smith is not, Will Smith is barely in that.
Yeah, if you think about it.
And he's great in it. The movie overall is bad, but the badness starts
when Will gets, he breaks his leg mm-hmm. and he gets stuck in the spaceship, and then Jaden takes over and it's bad.
That was
so it's a bad overall movie, but it's not Will Smith being bad in a movie.
I didn't
and that's
know
what happened.
It's a Jaden movie.
Yeah, it's a Jaden movie.
Okay, but I'm going to say this. Y'all Jaden say, okay, so if we're looking at Will Smith as an actor, then I guess I have to agree with you that young Will Smith is the best. However, I like old Will Smith because I feel like now he's become relevant in a different way to people. Now, mm-hmm. The first day on Instagram, he had like Man. Millions of views because he's now dropping gems. People are now listening to him because of all of the years of him being young Will. Mm-hmm. Now he's got something to tell you that you really can feel like I feel like I know him better as an old person than I did as just an actor.
When he's a wise he's owl. Lifted that veil and you get to see who he really is.
Yeah. Yeah.
Before Instagram, before celebrities got on Instagram, you didn't know other than like from interviews and movies, like who they were, what they liked, that type of stuff. So Instagram has kind of bridged that gap between the celebrity and the regular person.
And you know what? He's not as different as we thought he was. Like, yes, he's this multi-million dollar. Like before we was like, oh, he's just a guy who's into like Scientology and he's friends with Tom Cruise. Like he just seems mm-hmm. real mystical. But now it's like, oh, he's Fresh cool. Prince.
You know what? He said people. Denzel and Tom Cruise and them told him like movie stars need to be mysterious and you can't because that's how they came up. Denzel, like if you think about people like that, Denzel, Tom Cruise, Arnold Schwarzenegger, another person who told him that, they're not on Instagram.
Right.
And you only hear about them from the movie. So I'm gonna go with old Will Smith and I'm gonna tell you why. He is more personable as a social media person mm-hmm. and much more likable and you have more access to him. I feel like he's more, he's better at selling his movies now because he's just like, man, he's great. Red Table Talk, the stuff he be saying on there, mm-hmm. him as a parent, I'd be like, bro, y'all be parenting y'all kids mm-hmm. on some like, y'all need to be adults, so let y'all make decisions. The only problem is, and this is why I agree with Doughboy, we were introduced to Will, he kind of has like the Eddie Murphy thing. Mm-hmm. Their first 10 years were like so legendary that it's nearly impossible to keep that up. Mm-hmm. Like 10 movies over $100 million, like, He couldn't just keep doing
that.
He was missed the box office.
But think about it like this. Just like how you guys say, like, now you can see Will Smith and say, oh, he's on Instagram and da-da-da-da. Is it that you like Will Smith now as he's older or just the fact that you get access into his life? Because that would be a credit to Instagram, not Will Smith.
No.
Because 10 years ago, nobody didn't have access to
because
nobody.
There's a lot of people that are on Instagram that you don't like. Because no one does.
But what I'm saying is the fact that
we
have the access. We didn't have access like that to anybody 15 years ago.
Right,
so we couldn't even say if we would have liked that Will
He didn't have access to his movies, the horrible movies 15 years ago. What you can't look at the time as a determining factor. You have to look at what the person does with that time as a determining factor. Him getting on Instagram was a conscious decision. Instagram had already been around, so mm-hmm. he could have got on it when Instagram first popped off. He made the conscious decision to be on Instagram, to be more personable, to be more accessible. And because of that, mm-hmm. now you have people like, I don't know if y'all saw a couple weeks ago, Jackie Fabulous was on Instagram with Will Smith. Like she spent...
Jackie Fabulous
was like, they were in Vegas kicking it. She got video, pictures, everything with Will Smith. And I believe it's because he is so accessible now and because he's doing things more, encouraging people to reach out and he's doing these
but as far as the content that he gives you for you to like digest as far as him being an actor or an entertainer, mm-hmm. I feel the reason why I feel like he suffers in that because I feel like Will Smith was the ultimate cool guy for so long and like now he's like in that weird he's 50 now
but so he's
I feel
still like cool
but what I'm saying is he'll have his time where he can get his George Clooney on but we're still like looking at where's like you know box flat top Will like he's always been that quintessential cool dude but now he's like a little bit older so it's different. I feel like we just need to usher him into that part, but we've been in love with the young
You're talking
Will.
About his movie career?
Absolutely.
Well, that's
because now
I mean,
even when you
I
see
mean,
his movies, like it's like he's just so cool. It's just like some movies I can't even disconnect it because he's such a cool nigga. You see what I'm saying? Like he's the dude.
Nah, I never get that with him.
I get that with him with his movies.
I don't get that
I
with
mean,
him.
He,
and
when
I
he's
also,
playing the cool character in movies like Bad Boy or Focus or stuff, but when he's like Gemini Man, he's not playing a cool guy.
And that Brian, nobody wouldn't watch the movie because
I feel like now you said he plays a cool guy in all his movies.
He's at a part of his career now where he can take more risks with the movies that he wants to do. He can take like with Samuel Jackson. Not actually, is it Sam? Yeah, Sam. He takes roles just to stay relevant, I feel like.
Yes.
Right? Because he'll get in every type of movie. You'll be like, why is he even...
Yes.
Like some movies that you never saw at the movies, but just on Netflix.
Right.
He will hop in, and it's just like he is constantly expanding his brand. He's constantly expanding his reach. And he's at the point where he doesn't have to worry about a movie ruining his career just because it didn't do major numbers at the box office. To have that freedom, to have that security, to have that peace of mind is something that we all lust for.
Well, he's been doing that for the last 12 movies. And
I think he's like a, when a rapper starts picking a lot of bad beats, that's where he's at in his movie career. Like, I feel like he's like, okay, I can't do science fiction movies forever. Nas's career.
He hasn't done a good movie in 10 years.
But here's the thing, though. He's never bad in the movies. Like, in Suicide Squad, he was the only good part of that. That was a terrible movie. But that's not Will Smith's fault.
But then you still call it a bad Will Smith movie, right?
No, he had top 30 people in there.
What was the last really good Will Smith movie you guys watched? Just tell me.
Gemini Man.
I like White.
Have you seen it? You haven't even seen it. He didn't even see it.
I did see it.
I like Collateral Damage. Collateral Damage. He did good in Collateral Damage.
Really? What do you say really good? Yeah, he did really good. Compared to what?
Like that most people, the general consensus would be it was a great movie. I'm not even talking about numbers. Just tell me the last Will Smith movie we all can say that was fine because we all like
it. Happiness?
Collateral Damage.
Okay, that was in 06. That's making my point. That's 06.
But that's
no, I Am Legend was 07. Hancock, 08.
So what was the last good Will Smith movie that you love?
I say Collateral Damage.
I say Pursuit of Happiness.
He was really good in Aladdin. I really liked Aladdin. Yeah. I really liked Bright.
I like Bright.
But I wouldn't argue that Bright was a great movie.
Right.
I just didn't really mind it. I was really happy it was on Netflix.
Well, here's the other part of that, because old Will Smith had songs like Welcome to Miami.
Yeah,
and
I hated that.
I felt like I'm so glad he's old Will because he's not doing music anymore. Let's be real.
His music was fire.
Don't act like Millennium was
a remix. That's not his
One of the best songs in the world.
That is Jiggy with it, Summer the album now, Millennium.
Trash.
When we were kids, y'all were in your 20s, but
I always thought Millennium was a trash.
But when you go back and listen to it, it's terrible.
It was terrible.
His ABC rhymes have always been terrible, but because he was young Will Smith, we like that.
Ain't no way old Will Smith is cutting a hot record.
We don't want him to. He recognized
that. I didn't like Will when he was
on the album. But that's not his album.
That freestyle was fire. When he was on Jaden's remix?
Yeah.
Here's the thing about the Icon remix?
Yes,
and I'm going to be an Icon chilling. And you're an Icon villain. Now I'm an Icon villain.
Bars.
No. I never liked Will Smith as a rapper outside of Summertime.
There was no real Smith song that I was like, oh, I can't
Getting
wait.
Jiggy with it?
You got it.
No, not even on my street.
Bag with a lot of stuff in it. Give it to your friends. Let's spin.
Just because we all knew it.
Stuff in it. Come on,
Tier. Never ever liked Will Smith.
Nas wrote that.
Nah,
you got a Prada bag with a lot of stuff in it.
Paris just don't understand.
I don't even know what song you're singing right now.
Paris just don't understand.
What about just the two of us, man?
That was fire. Talking about his child.
Just
the two of us was cool, but like I never longed to hear it.
But here's what
like
nobody
he wasn't a lyricist.
What
baby was
that? Nope, that was Trey. That was Trey, his first baby.
That was Trey.
You don't be seeing him a lot.
Now, he does the music for his vlogs.
Oh, okay,
yeah. That's cool.
Shout out to him. Friend.
We have no one's mentioned this. Young Will had the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, which is one of the greatest sitcoms of all time.
So much so that I started a Facebook page
all the way because
it's easy.
You said Young Will?
Yeah, I'm Young Will all the way because of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Independence Day.
Bad Boys, the original.
Bad Boys too, but more so, I feel like Enemy of the State was the first movie that he showed that range. It was amazing.
That's one of my favorite Will Smith movies.
Absolutely, hands
by far.
Yeah. It's one of my favorite movies.
And your girl, like, Regina King, is in that.
Ooh, she had on the lingerie.
That was the first time you said she was a present.
Can we just pause and acknowledge how great of a career she has had? She literally has...
Boys in the Hood.
227, she started. Yes. She did six seasons of
Friday.
That. Boys in the Hood, Friday, Enemy of the State.
Did she do Boondocks or was that Regina Hall?
Yes. No, that's Regina King.
Yeah.
And she did Huey and Riley.
Seven Seconds.
And she did
Watchmen.
Watchmen is
just killed in that.
Watchmen, I think, is her best thing to date.
She directed that episode of Insecure that I was on.
Yes.
When we were in the Hollywood.
She did that episode?
Yeah, she directed that episode.
Yeah,
she really has.
When I was on Insecure, you know.
She missed the two seasons.
She hasn't picked bad in a, I can't think of a thing that I saw Regina King in that
but
I didn't like.
But that's what I feel like Will Smith does. I feel like he picks bad projects later in his career.
In his defense, later in his career, he switched over to producing. So he produced Another Karate Kid with Jaden. That was a good movie.
That was a good movie.
It was two and a half hours.
And that made money,
too. That was a great movie.
It doesn't make it a good movie.
He produced it.
My favorite part of that movie was Jaden hit that boy, and that boy fell.
I thought it was too long.
Right back up.
It was long.
I loved it.
I tried to watch it.
All right, so let's do a final recap.
No, man, I still want to talk about it.
Nah, man, we got to move on to left. We got one more. Because we got one more.
Wait, I didn't give you a time signal?
Yes.
I want to say something.
I'm giving you a time signal.
Pat wants to say things.
I want
to
say things and stuff.
Pat wants to say things.
Some points.
Pat, say some words.
All right, I'm going to make some points.
Okay. That's enough.
I'm going to still go. Old Will is cool because of everything that happened in his younger career. We have all that wisdom that you're talking about comes from all that other stuff. If you took all of that out, he would just be a really, really good influencer. True. And I think he's doing IG really in a cool way.
He's the best celebrity at it.
Because he's never written his movies. He's never been a writer. So we never really got to see his creativity, only his execution.
And he said that on Instagram and YouTube. He said, this is giving me the chance to be creative in my own way.
Yeah. Right.
And that's why he puts, because you can tell he's putting more into his content on social media than other celebrities are.
Exactly.
He's not just throwing stuff up. Them vlogs, you see how well his vlogs are edited?
He has crazy editing. Their team is wild.
Bro, he'd be on the top of castles in Budapest. Like, that is personal. So, yes, I agree with your point 100%.
But here's why I'm going with Young Will. If you were to say, okay, if you were given this option, you have to sit down like Clockwork Orange style, like strapped, like looking at a TV, and you had to watch all of his young projects or all of his old projects and his Instagrams.
You would take Young Will.
I would.
That's a great point. Come on.
That's a good point.
All right, I guess I'm gonna switch to Young Will.
Yeah,
that might have been his.
Is it unanimous? Then?
No, I'm staying with Old Will.
Just to spite us.
Just to spite us.
That's some old nigga shit.
You old nigga.
Why? Because
I don't like that change of time.
I'm eating the same cereal, watching the same video. I just like his Instagram. I like his YouTube. Like, I get so inspired by his YouTube. I think he's much more creative than I ever thought he was. I thought he was always a great actor and other stuff, but like you said, I feel like he's more interesting now as a person overall.
So you would watch all that over his old movies?
No.
Exactly. So then you got to come to Young Will.
I don't have to do anything.
You do.
I'll fight you, nigga.
That was just a really
old, angry ass man. All right, so let's do a final recap, Pat.
Young Will.
Young Will.
Young Will.
Young Will.
Willennium.
That's Young Will.
Proud of. In it. That
all
was
right,
great.
So moving on to the last topic that we will be voting on today or debating on today, rap versus R&B.
Let's start over there this time.
Oh, my God. Rap. I've never been a huge fan of R&B, to be honest.
Or lotion.
Your ankles are
ass. Why ain't you got no socks on, nigga?
He never wears socks. Pat does not wear socks. Somebody,
who kicked you out this morning before you can put your socks on?
You know who kicked him out this morning.
But you got somewhere to
be. You do have lotion. Really, though, why don't you be wearing socks? They don't feel weird
feet
in your
stink
shoes.
When you take
you
them
never
off.
Wear socks. That's so weird.
You wear socks and your feet stink.
Why don't you wear socks?
Yeah,
I do wear socks.
When?
Just sometimes.
They don't. Your feet don't feel weird with the shoe directly on it? I need a separation of church.
I feel like all your shoes stink.
Yeah. I feel like I feel the outside.
The sock is like the condom for the foot.
Okay.
What? It is.
You're not protecting your foot.
You're not wrong. Yeah. Athlete's foot and it smells.
Okay. Anyway, you don't like R&B.
I'm not a huge fan of R&B. There are some R&B songs that I can get with, but I don't be listening to like...
Them girls be listening to R&B when they're done with you, though. They be like, forget him, I'm sick of him. He came over here with that old earthy smell. Summer Walker is in rotation because of you.
I'm for sure going with rap.
I be speeding away listening to Young Thug.
Now see, I'm going to actually throw a curveball. I actually thought at first I would say rap, you know, because I just finished the Wonder Years album. It's on the way. Make sure you guys listen to that.
You finished the Wonder Bread album.
But
peanut butter and jelly sandwiches on the way.
Every track is like a recipe.
With bread. Monkey bread.
But this song's called French
The reason why I would say R&B, because most of the rap music I listen to, you know what I'm saying, it's like street-oriented music. Y'all know I come from a street background. I know that. But with R&B, it's like more love. It's like more love and feelings.
I don't care.
And I like to feel my feelings these days. So I like you I be think crying? R&B. I cry.
Listen to R&B? What album be making you cry?
Faith Evans.
You still listen to that?
Absolutely.
Really?
So her first one.
The old stuff?
Oh, yeah. I don't like new R&B. Oh, like
that
new
whole
R&B
crying
is
listening
trash.
To Faith Evans?
Really?
Absolutely.
Wow. Speed past that vision.
I did not expect Faith Evans from you at all.
Absolutely. Right. And Mary J. Blige, too. First album.
Mary,
of my
I can
life.
See. She's extra. You're extra.
Oh, that was
sense.
Her best.
What is your house? What?
She's just in the dark crying. And I'm not.
It's a box of tissues.
Every room.
I'm not
not going to shed a tear.
Oh, that's what?
You don't be in no mood. You just be turning
around. No, I just
crying.
Like it because like even when you listen to like older R&B, it's like they talk about love and just situations and life. And it makes me feel more than rap. A lot of these rappers just, I mean, this is coming from a rapper, but I like R&B.
Yeah.
I'm going to say R&B. For really? Sure. Because think about it. Like, first of all, there's a lot of rap samples that come from R&B songs.
Good
okay,
point.
You would not have the beat if you didn't have R&B, that's number good. One. Number two, R&B has been around way longer, has evolved.
It just has different names. Still, it's like soul music.
It went from like blues, mm-hmm. then rhythm and blues, and now you got like another version of it. It's
Trap Soul,
around.
Bryson Tiller.
You got Neo Soul and all of
yeah,
that.
You got all, it's
you got
still
Soul
going
Food
around.
R&B with Doughboy. It's mostly things about fried
work.
Chicken.
I didn't
want it to work.
Soul Food R&B.
And I mean, even so much so now, like, you got so many people who are different cultures that are not just black that are doing R&B who are singing from their soul. It just does something to you. I don't get goosebumps when I hear somebody rap, but I get goosebumps when I hear these wonderful R&B songs. Okay?
Kevin gets goosebumps when the microwave timer goes.
Jesus
Christ.
I just hit you so many times.
Kevin gets goosebumps.
In your eyes, you didn't believe in that.
Now, wait, Kev, before you give your opinion, where would we put like a Bryson Tiller? Is he more hip hop or is he more R&B?
He's trap soul.
No, he's trap R&B.
Soul. R&B elements
no,
in rap now.
Yes. No, but that's what I'm saying. So it's R&B because you would put him in R&B. He's not, if you hear him, he's singing.
Okay. No, but he'd be like rap singing too.
Yeah,
he's
because
like
him,
he's kind of like
Party Next Door.
Tory Lanez.
Tory Lanez. Like, where do they fall
they're
in this gray area?
They're R&B singers.
Because Tory Lanez is a rapper.
Oh, yeah. Kick is a rapper. He's a rapper.
Wow. He would be hip hop artist. If you look Tory Lanez up, I'm gonna look him up.
He came up doing remix of R&B songs.
But he raps though.
And he said he was a king of R&B.
But he also said he's the best rapper.
I thought that was Jacquees.
Well, I guess for these people that I mean, I would say you put their projects in different buckets. Like if they're rapping, then they're rappers.
You know what it is about it? I think I agree with Meg. I don't think artists today fit neatly into buckets like they used to. We allow them to rap and sing. Before in the 90s, you were a rapper, you rap.
Yeah.
You were a singer, you sing. I feel like Kanye, Cuddy, they allowed, you know, artists to, you know,
move
I mean,
evolve.
Yeah. Even Outkast back in the day, they were singing and stuff like that, but it was like, it wasn't like you're an R&B artist or a rapper.
Man, I like R&B, like the older stuff, like Joe or Chico DeBar.
I'm a 90s R&B head.
Listen,
to this
I'm
going to
tell you something. I agree, but I feel like the last 2 or 3 years of R&B, these artists have been killing it.
Summer Walker,
Ari Lennox, her. Daniel Caesar Salad. Snow Allegra has a great project.
Oh, my gosh. Yes.
Sabrina Claudio. If y'all don't know.
Yes. Oh, yes. She's good.
Yeah, like
she's
there's
good.
A lot of really solid, I mean, I'm like really good, you know, back to four. PJ Morton, there's a lot of great albums out. Like I feel like, and this is I've never been a crazy rap person, and I realize rappers are writing songs and stuff like that, but I feel like the best written songs are R&B songs. Like when you write, like Best Part, just take Best Part with Daniel Caesar and her. Like the first time I heard that, I was like, this is one of the best songs I've heard ever. Like I can literally imagine getting
best
married.
Again. Oh, you know how many, you know how many weddings.
What do you know?
Okay, I was going to say marriages. Yeah. I meant to say
absolutely.
Weddings got best part.
You still struggling
just
to
get
wet.
It out, nigga.
I haven't eaten this morning. My sugar's low.
But no, but as soon as that song came out,
oh
I could.
God.
That's
John Legend song. That John Legend song that he's killing.
That's one thing I will say is that R&B will dominate over a lot more events than hip hop will when it comes to like functions. Like you got Before I Let Go, always at every barbecue, every family picnic, every family gathering. Then you got the artists like Joe, when the kids go down. Like these R&B will always have that place. So, however, I will always pick hip hop because I feel like there's a, even with hip hop being more aggressive and having a heavier
tone.
Wait,
we're not talking about hip hop. We're talking about rap.
Okay. Well, even with rap having a heavier tone.
Is it different?
Hip hop's not rap.
It's a different.
Rap is rap. Isn't hip hop the culture overall?
Hip hop is the culture.
Hip hop's the culture. It includes beatboxing, breakdancing, streetwear.
Don't nobody really be breakdancing no more.
You don't.
Graffiti.
Yeah, they do. In New York.
That was one of the worst things you've ever seen. You break down when you turn around like you killed it.
I thought for sure I was going to hit the laugh. I waited for the laughter. Roaring applause.
That was never coming.
These guys get it. Shut the hell up. Okay, cool.
Hello, this thing on? I feel like you can do a lot of things to rap music. Like you can work out to it, can get you motivated. Yeah. You can ride around with the homies with it.
You can even
smash to rap songs. You can
smashing the Future.
Yeah, you're not. Well, I wouldn't say Future. I was thinking like more like the Tory Lanez, like the Drakes and things of that nature. But you can't ride around with the homies like listening to Summer Walker. Like I'm not saying that I don't listen to rap music
because y'all all looked at me crazy. Nobody else be smashing the rap music?
I don't smash the music.
I don't smash the music either.
Yeah, that's really? The science. Yeah, y'all are super
Kevin, you don't smash the gospel
that.
Music?
Why is that weird? No.
What do you mean? You be, like, you be cranking up the Hezekiah.
Fred Hammond had a romance album. You didn't
he
get
did,
that?
No. Yeah.
So you don't smash the music?
That is actually worse.
Hold on.
I'd rather have sex to regular R&B than gospel artists making R&B music.
Wait, so it just be quiet when y'all have
sex? Yeah, girl, your body's like the bosom of the Lord. Don't.
You don't smash the music. Patrick don't smash the music.
Yeah.
What do you all like? You're have like a, those things that you click and then the speakers raise.
No,
and
no
we have a phone. We have a Bluetooth speaker in a playlist.
You smash the ba da ba ba ba.
He smashes to mukbangs. All right, tonight's gonna be a seafood boil. You ready, girl? Oh,
but no, I don't have sex with music. I used to try to do it just to be like, yeah, we will set the mood, and then I'm gonna tell you why I stopped originally.
I like hearing that.
I'm gonna tell you why. I had Pandora. This is before I had the money for Pandora One, and I put it like on an R&B station, and then the ad would come in. I'd be like,
O'Reilly's Auto Parts.
Y'all ain't making playlists.
This before playlists. No. All I had was Pandora.
Back in the day, before that, you have a mix CD, you were making your own.
Never mind.
No, but dude, I'll tell you why I stopped making playlists though, because it's real embarrassing when you only make it through 2.5 of the songs and it's like, oh, but
that's embarrassing, like, period. That ain't got nothing to do with playlists.
Oh, gosh.
If you took the music out of that, she'd still be like,
yeah, what are you doing?
She doesn't need like something to measure it with. All right, well, when did I park my car?
She can tell. She's counting Mississippi.
It'd be embarrassing if the music still be playing. I turn the shit off. Shit, I'm done.
And it's always weird when I used to smash the music. When you get done, you're just like, oh, I'm done with this. Like rolling over to turn the phone off.
You keep the music going. Like,
yeah,
like,
keep the mood.
You gotta keep the music going. Don't get the towel. I'm tired now.
Enough of the other stuff. Rolling over to turn the phone off.
This makes so much sense. Why the first thing we were debating, y'all pick food.
Yeah. I'll play some music for that. Put on that red dress.
Get home, I eat the whole damn plate.
I'm making love to you. Now you're talking about saying the move. I put the candles on.
That
the
is
now
that
you're
is
talking.
Disturbing.
You got a candlelight dinner for two, but it's just you.
I was gonna say this too. R&B, everybody can relate to because it talks about love, and everybody has dealt with love in some way, shape, or fashion. You like somebody, somebody didn't like you, something.
Yeah.
And that never gets old. That crosses the test of time. But when it comes to rap, not everybody can take what's said in rap and make it relevant to themselves.
You know
not everybody grew up in the streets. Not everybody.
No. I'm gonna disagree with
not
you.
Not everybody early had rap, money yes. hoes.
No. But listen, not everybody. Early '90s rap when it was all money, drugs, hoes,
gangster
rap. Agree. Lately, rappers be talking about everything. Yep. Like
they're as sensitive as R&B.
Yes, they really do. Like Jim Crow the Musical. I don't know if you've heard it. It's literally a whole song. I mean, a whole album about the black struggle in America.
Oh, yeah.
Like that stuff. Kanye wasn't talking about none of that. Drake don't be
talking
about
guns.
Kanye
never talked about killing people.
Yeah. Like, so when that music was like Kid Cudi, when that even like Tyler the Creator, he'd be having like really like colorful.
He'd be getting people through stuff too.
Yeah. Now rappers and I gotta take this back. Rappers be telling great stories as well. Mm-hmm. I just don't connect as much with that. Street life stuff, but like the baby, man, the baby's
fantastic.
The baby's
amazing. Another
fun.
One.
Now, here's the other thing about rap, though, that it has over R&B. A live performance of a rap song is much more interesting than an R&B.
I absolutely agree.
That depends on the artist.
Listen to your award shows. On your award shows, the more ones that we remember. They're very rarely R&B performances. They're almost always rap performances.
Because here's the thing. Rap is fun, okay? So, like, when you think about it, when you're thinking of a fun vibe, you're not thinking about R&B. R&B is mellow, cool, chill love. But when you're watching an award show, you don't want mellow, cool, chill love. You want fun. You want hype. You want the lights. You want movement. Yeah. You want dancing. You want all that stuff. So that's why that stuff is more memorable. But at the end of the day, like, when you take it outside of the fun element, really, when
concert,
do you... Yeah,
I
when can you listen
to
it?
A concert's... different because that's like that artist's whole vibe.
Do they perform like slow R&B? I've never been to an R&B concert. Do they perform their slow hits?
Yeah,
absolutely. And people sing.
I couldn't see myself being at a concert like...
Man, well, that's a different Claudio vibe. Concert.
Why are you doing that at any concert?
No, for live performances, I feel like rappers have it easier because rappers rarely say every word that they say on the
The hype men do.
They do a lot of this in rap concerts.
They have a backing track. They can be more ridiculous, which is why the award shows, they can have like dancers and all this stuff going on. Whereas an R&B performance is mostly skill, because unless you got auto-tune, like you see who's good and who's not from R&B. Like somebody who's like really good at singing and they kill it live, like that's a better performance, really, than Migos just like standing there with the backtrack on.
Right. So. Mm-hmm.
Well, all
except
right.
Except like, what is before you finish? Is Bruno Mars considered R&B or pop?
Pop.
Okay. Because his concert was amazing.
Oh yeah.
It's all up tempo, you know, music. It ain't like
don't believe me. Just
I've never been to a straight R&B concert either. Because Beyonce's considered pop.
R&B.
Who?
Can you have art up tempo R&B?
I don't. Is it considered pop then? If it's too up tempo though,
I don't think pop is the tempo.
I think it is.
Like, well, what is Lizzo considered pop music? Right.
Yeah.
Fun fact I wanted to throw in. Did y'all know
we didn't finish this current thing we were talking about? Is there any R&B artist who makes some up to tempo stuff?
I don't know. I mean, because now you're talking about the musicality of the genre.
I mean, yeah, because hold on. You have, like, I would consider Jill Scott R&B, but then she's got, like, some of her stuff is faster paced.
Yeah, like Golden would be Golden R&B, right? Yeah.
So speed determines the genre?
No, I don't think so. The tempos of R&B songs are generally slower, but and that I think it's like
if you do most of your music maybe a little bit slower, maybe you're ethnic, maybe, you know, I feel like those are some of the lines that traditionally have people have fallen into R&B.
Oh, okay.
But I don't think it's like, I don't know. Yeah.
What about Anderson .Paak? What is he considered? Because you told me that's the best concert you've ever been to.
Neo Soul.
That's under the R&B
umbrella. Yeah, it's
that's R&B. Definitely R&B though, right? But you said that was great.
Man, it was the best concert. I've seen them 3 times now. I saw him here. I saw him in Vegas.
Dang,
and I saw him down
he
San
drove
Diego.
To Vegas on like a Tuesday.
Yes.
Wow. And came back.
Yeah.
And all of his shows are to have been
and
the
was
best.
Like not sad about it. He was like, Kev, I'd do it again.
Absolutely.
And I wanted to go see Anderson .Paak ever since, but I haven't seen him in LA.
You drove back after the concert?
Yes.
At what time was it?
I don't know.
He was just so happy. He don't even
Josh just sent me a picture of Anderson .Paak, was like light flex. I was like, fuck you, Josh. Because I've never got a chance to meet him. Like, I've been wanting to meet him, but like, yo.
Did you meet Anderson .Snacks? Because that's you.
You just had that one locked and loaded.
No, it just popped in.
That's the whole reason you brought up Anderson.
I was like, snacks. All right, I'm sticking with R&B.
I'm saying R&B.
I'm sticking with hip hop. Rap.
I'm sticking with R&B.
Rap.
All right.
You can't whip up no coke to the stuff you're talking about.
Yes, you can.
At the end of the day.
That'd be funny. An R&B singer sold drugs and they made the music that way. So anyway, I'm going to be talking now.
All
right. I already started. You want to close it out?
No, go ahead. Close it up.
This is the first Squadcast I've had so much.
We're going to call it Squadcast?
Squadcast. I miss you, friend.
I miss you guys. And you know what's crazy about it?
What?
Not a beat was missed.
Yes.
Nope,
it's been probably a cool
6 months.
The install.
No. Us longer. All in the video?
Yeah, awesome.
Oh. Because I was gone since October of 2018.
Oh, wow.
So I was gone October 2017.
You left in October?
October.
Me too.
Because I went to Italy like the next week.
Light flex.
Yeah.
No, I got, that's just how I remember it. I wasn't even like that.
I was in Paris.
Well, you went to Olive Garden that night, so I know you know what I'm talking. I was doing a tour of Italy, and so were you. So anyway, make sure y'all subscribe on podcast. Turn the notifications on the YouTube channel. We back.
Yes.
Black. We'll be back here every Monday. Set your alarm clocks to us because we back.
Broke boys.
And do we want to take suggestions? If you have suggestions, hit to hear us. Yes. Yeah, take hit to hear on what do you want? Twitter, DM, Instagram?
Twitter and I guess IG probably be the easiest.
Yeah, hit them up for ideas. Again, this is not a trending show. It's just never going to be that.
No.
Unless the timing just happens to hit it.
Yeah.
But we're never trying to make it like that because we talk about it on our podcast. But if you guys have ideas, hit to hear up because it's y'all show as much as it is ours. But if you don't have ideas, we have our own. See you next time, cuz.
Bye.
Like I smell. Stone.